then how can you speak miraculously as an adult? How can he speak miraculously as an adult? Our big problem with the Ahmadiyya movement or the Qadianis is not so much the claim of Mirza Ghulam Ahmad that he's a Nabi. That's the red herring. That's the skillfully constructed diversion. And they put the bait for us, and all going on that way. No, no, our essential problem, biggest problem of all, with Mirza Ghulam Ahmad and the Ahmadiyya movement, but the IMF is not interested in this subject. No, no. Is that they claim that Nabi Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, that he was not crucified, but that rather he lived until he was an old man. And then he traveled all the way to Kashmir and he died and he was buried there. And this Prophet of Allah, who was sent into the world as a prophet, from the day that they attempted the crucifixion, until the day when they say he was buried in Kashmir, he remained outside of public view. No one saw him. No one knew him. It's just a total blank on the page of his life. Does this make sense? That a prophet of God would remain silent like a hermit inside a cave and have nothing whatsoever to say to the world for most of his life? No, no, no. In the Caribbean, we have a way to respond to that. We say, crick, crack, the wire bend, and that's the way the story ends. It's a fable. But it's a very dangerous fable. They reject the belief that he will speak miraculously as an adult. And Allah says in the Quran, how can he speak miraculously as an adult when he was silent, absolutely silent, all his life until he went to Kashmir and he died and he buried him? Where is the miraculous speech as an adult? We say the miraculous speech, the miracle, is that yes, he was not crucified. Allah made it appear like that, and Allah took him away. And when he comes back, he will speak again. That is the miracle. That he will speak fil mahdi wa kahla, miraculously. And this is the Quran demonstrating, providing you with the evidence that he will return. This is at the heart of Islamic eschatology. This is at the heart of this Christian eschatology. And this is what Ahmadiyya has come to try to destroy. This is why the world of Islam looks upon Ahmadiyya as a grave threat. And if you come in our way, we're going to take care of you. Do not stand in our way. Our message to Ahmadiyya. If you want to live with us, but you do not constitute a threat to us, and you do not join with the enemies of Islam to try to destroy us, which includes the IMF, then you can live with us. Yes. We can allow you, we have a constitutional agreement where we can allow you to live peacefully in our midst. And you can come in the market and you can buy and sell like all of us. And your properties will be safe, your life will be safe. That's right. And you can continue with your Ahmadiyya beliefs. But if you come in our way and you constitute a threat and you want to take control of the economic advisory board on behalf of the IMF, no, the people of Pakistan have every right to stand up immediately. Stop it. And this is an indication that Pakistan knows the danger. And so Nabi Isa alayhi salam will return.